laugh at myself comparing my kids to yours all the time. And because they seem perfect, I feel like I suck as a mom. This is a huge problem, and it really robs all of us of living our best lives. And if you're anything like me, you probably wrestle with this thing on the daily. And that thing is comparison. Recently, I came across this quote that said, "I never really learned how to just like something. I always let it consume me." And I thought, man, with this ongoing wrestle with comparison, that's exactly where I often find myself. And so I had to ask, is it possible to be inspired without getting caught in the comparison trap? Like, just because X person is talented, creative, and doing all the things that they love, does that mean that I have to feel crappy about myself? Me and one of my best friends have had some really hard and raw conversations about comparison. Sometimes we compare each other with each other and compete with each other without even realizing it. And though it's been so tough to own up to the times our hearts get jealous or smug over the good things happening in our lives, I'm seeing how comparison's grip on us is getting weaker and weaker the more we talk about it and the more we confront the real reasons behind why we feel like we need to be someone else. On my Instagram, I asked if anyone ever felt like they have these moments where they look at someone else who's their age and think to themselves, what the hell am I doing with my life? And if you're around the same age as me, you can find yourself riding around with your woes, looking at Drake's success, or Taylor Swift, or even Beyonce. And a friend of mine actually bravely DM'd me and confessed that she compares herself to me. And as the week went on, I realized that I was comparing myself to one particular girl on Instagram that I was initially inspired by because she's doing all of the things that I love and that I know that I'm made for. And so all of this got me digging and thinking, am I capable of being inspired and admiring someone without wanting to be them? But I wish this was our reality. I wish that everywhere we went and no matter who we met, we could celebrate the beauty of the spaces we enter and appreciate the unique people we encounter by letting them teach us and challenge us. But instead, I feel like comparison just gets in the way of all of that goodness that can be birthed from our connection to one another. Comparison is sneaky. It's the enemy of inspiration. I feel like if inspiration inspires you to be more fully you, comparison instead demands that you become more like them. And way, way too often do I find myself feeling genuinely inspired. Yet before I know it, I want to do exactly what that person is doing. I want their life and I want to be them. And lately I've had to stop myself in the middle of doing and creating because I had to ask if I was going after these things because I wanted to try something new or tap into something that I've always been interested in. Or am I just really trying to be the person that I am so-called inspired by? You and I weren't made to be like anyone else. We were made to be us. And though we say we know that and can chant that all day as our mantra, it's pretty difficult to live in that reality. Like really, think about it. There has never been nor ever will be another Cameron Nicole Lindo. Even if I were to name all my kids after me, they'd still all be intrinsically different. So I am it. Me, right now, which means I'm a history maker in and of myself because God has decided that there will only be one me. That's all I got. That's all you get. Just me. And friend, the same goes for you. You are one of a kind. There has never been nor ever will be another you. And that is world changing in and of itself. We all have similarities amongst each other, but none of us is exactly alike. We're all different with varying passions, quirks, fears, giftings, strengths and struggles, stories and shortcomings. But the lie that we often fall to is that we're too different, that we're not enough because we don't fit into any mold of who this world demands us to be. And so we strive for sameness, competing and comparing to be just like someone or everyone else. And eventually we completely lose ourselves in the process. Comparison will have you out here looking silly. chasing after someone else's life that pretty soon you won't even know who you really are and what you really want anymore because you've believed the lie that you need to be them and need to have what they have. Which for me explains why I can often feel lost and confused and doubtful about the projects I have my hands in, because deep down, I'm just trying to make them look like the success stories of what's already been done. But I'm reminded that God is infinitely creative and always wants to do a new thing. Friend, he's not interested in making our lives look just like the next person. He just wants us to allow his goodness and power to manifest uniquely in us in a way that we nor the world has ever seen or known. And when we compare our lives to others, when we start to chase after creating a life that matches someone else's, we're actually silently saying that God isn't powerful or capable enough to use the personality, gifts, passions, and interests he's intentionally placed within us and the experiences he's carried us through for our own good and for his glory. We start to believe our own life story isn't worthy of transformation, so we settle for striving to make our story look like the beauty we see outside of ourselves. Comparison will also have you thinking that perfection is real and achievable. When we look at other people's lives, especially on social media, it's like this curated version of the best moments of their life that they choose to let you in on. And it's easy to forget that when you're constantly seeing pretty pictures, perfectly plated meals, and a put-together family. It'll give off this perception of perfection that will entice us into wanting the same perfect life for ourselves. But we all know perfection isn't real. So instead of assuming people's lives are perfect, instead of assuming everything is what it seems, dig beneath the surface and ask questions. Now, you may not have easy access to everyone to be able to do this, but I challenge you that when you find yourself comparing your life to a friend or even someone online, I challenge you to slide in those DMs or send that text and ask, what's the biggest struggle or insecurity they wrestle with in whatever area you find yourself envying, jealous, or comparing? Now, no, you don't have to go so far as to say, I find myself comparing my kids to yours all the time, and because they seem perfect, I feel like I suck as a mom. But you can simply ask, hey, what's motherhood like for you? What challenges do you face? What worries you? And if they're brave enough to respond, I think pretty quickly you'll find that the grass isn't really greener on the other side. That the very people you admire and look up to are just as human as you. They have fears, they're winging it and don't know what the heck they're doing. And they're probably stuck on the same hamster wheel of comparing themselves to others and striving to be perfect too. If we really want to beat comparison and live free from it, then we can't keep running. We have to admit that we struggle with it. We have to dare to look it in the eye and push ourselves to be vulnerable and honest and authentic so that every tendency within us to want to be someone else dies. So as you navigate through your week, I want you to be super aware of your thoughts and your emotions this week. When you get on social media, when you get around certain people, what are the emotions that rise up? Take to heart these thoughts on comparison. And I know sometimes it's not easy to recognize when you're comparing yourself or when you're jealous or when those feelings of envy are rising up. So you don't want to admit that those things are there. But you can often know that you're in a comparison trap or are envying someone else or are jealous of someone else. When you start to look at someone else's life and then start to create a list of things that you wish you could have and you wish you could be and you wish you could be doing. Things that they have that you wish were yours. I don't want this to be just another inspirational message that goes in one ear and out the other, one that just stays in your head but never really transfers into your heart or translates into your life. I really want to come alongside you and help you crush comparison, because I know that this is an ongoing problem that we all wrestle with because we're human. I have created a little freebie for you that you can download on my site in the description below. It'll help you in a practical way to be able to be aware of when you're comparing yourself to someone else and help you to crush comparison and live an inspired life. Who do you often feel like you struggle with comparing yourself to? Let me know in the comments below and stay tuned for next week as the series continues on how to crush comparison and live inspired.